大家，给他们刷个鼓声，好不好？Well done. Okay, well, Mike and Lillian, let's, we'll just get you settled in there. And let's tell you what you're going to take away with you tonight. You've won a carriage clock, a video recorder, a microwave oven, and £200. You had a nice night with us. Thanks for being with us, Mike. And Lillian. I'll see you in another 8 years. Just kiss. Lovely to see you. All right, there we are. Well done. Thank you very much indeed. And Winston and Jackie, you've won a gold ring and a personal computer. Is that okay for you? Thank you. Thanks for being great sports. Thanks for joining us. See you, Jackie.
All the best for the kids. Look after them.
And Leslie and Dave, you've already won a portable TV, golf clubs, a holiday in the Italian lakes and mountains, £100, a chance now to win that jackpot. Let's give them all a nice round of applause. Dave and Leslie, you like to go through? Coming up. Leslie, let's take your place. And there we go. OK. Now, here's how we play the end game. You play the game as you did before, but this time you play the game horizontally and vertically. I'll ask you which move you want to make. You shout out top, middle or bottom. If you look at the screens there now, you can see we've got 10 arrows, 10 questions and 10 hotspots. If a question comes up, it'll be true or false. You give me an incorrect answer, it becomes a hotspot. For a correct answer, you gain another move. If you go for our top money tonight of £5,000, no more than 2 hotspots, £4,000, no more than 3, and 3, no more than 4. If you go for our top money and you fail to get right the way across, we give you £500 for every successful move you make. Before you make your mind up, the computer will now jumble them all up. That's it, they've gone. OK, your prizes are saved, so you want to go for £3,000, £4,000 or £5,000. What do you think they should do?
£5,000.
They're going for the £5,000. Let's wish them the best of luck. Have you done, Dave? You just stand about here. Keep that gap there.
Yeah.
Our rail will be. OK. In case you notice, our rail's missing, because we needed to get the chair over. All right. Yes. OK, for your first £500, top, middle or bottom, where do you think they should go? Down the bottom? You want to go down the bottom for the first 500? Come on! Oh, question. All right. The colour vermilion is a deep green. Is that true or false?
False.
That's right, it's red, £500. OK, you're on your way. All right, OK, for £1,000, top, middle or bottom, where do you want to go? Top, middle or bottom? Up the top for £1,000, come on! Ooh! This one will allow you one more, OK? For £1,000 on this one, top, middle or bottom, where do you want to go?
Bottom.
Down the bottom again?
Yes.
Down the bottom for £1,000, come on! Yes, that's it, we're on the way. OK, for £1,500, top, middle or bottom, where are you going to go?
Top.
Up the top, up to the top for £1,500, yeah! Ooh. All right, you've still got your £1,000. No more hotspots will allow you. If a question comes up, you've got to get it right, OK? Just come over a little bit more. All right, for this time, for £1,500, the top, the middle or the bottom, you can't have a hotspot. Where are you going to go?
Bottom again, she
down
said.
Down the bottom for £1,500, come on. Oh, bang, like, let's give him a nice round of applause. Come on, Leslie, you stand here. Dave, come round this side, well done. Let's have a look at the screens and see where they all work. Oh, all right. Well, it's a bit of a maze to get through there, but it has been. I mean, you're still not going to go away empty-handed. You won tonight a portable television, the golf clubs, a holiday in Italy, the money you won earlier, plus the money you won there, £1,100 as well. OK, you had a nice day with us?
Lovely.
All right, all the best. Look after yourself, Leslie. See you again sometime. And you, Dave. And we'll see you again sometime. Same time next week, probably. Good night, God bless. All right, good night. Thank you. Goodbye. Thank you.
Stay out of the hotspots and get set to steal if you can, because lucky us, there's more Strike It Lucky next on Challenge. Weekdays at 4, Simon Mayo does his best Bob Holness and takes charge of those hexagons for Blockbusters.
Congratulations, number 3. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
F1 is about to hit the pause button, but before it does, it's time for the Belgian Grand Prix, sure to make you feel better.
It's lights out and away we go. Here comes Hamilton and they make contact!
What an idiot!
A favourite for drivers.
Every driver loves this track.
Has a very good flow.
and you don't want to lose it.
A favourite for fans.
Can't beat watching from Eru.
Esteban Ocon, around one, around another.
He's been in a class of one, hasn't he?
The Belgian Grand Prix. To add Sky Sports, go to sky.com/sports. If you needed a reason to stay with us, then we've got a million of them. Chris is here to play Classic Millionaire. Weeknights at 10, new on Challenge.
66. Give us a clickety-click if you can still hear us. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
On Strike It Lucky tonight, a jackpot of £5,000. Fun, sun and sea. Win a holiday in Tenerife. Banish those laundry blues with a new washing machine. Or sample the calm loveliness of a holiday in Corsica. All these prizes to be won tonight on Strike It Lucky. Ladies and gentlemen, your host, Michael Barrymore.
Thank you. Thank you. Here we go. Good evening. Thank you very much. Thank you. What? What a man. Nice to see you. Good evening. Hi, and Natasha.
How are you?
You're very okay. Well, thank you.
You all right?
Yes. Yeah?
And
Adrian.
How are you? Nice to meet you. Are you two married?
No, we're engaged.
Engaged. And when's the big day?
September.
Did he propose to you?
He did, yeah.
Yeah? And how did he do that?
In a forest.
Yeah. I had my tights on.
I had my tights on.
You
had your tights on, Adrian. Oh, I see. Anything else you want to tell us, Adrian, before we carry on? Whereabouts are you from?
From Essex.
Essex. What do you do, Natasha?
I'm a buyer's assistant for a retail company.
Yeah. And Adrian?
I'm a recruitment consultant for the construction industry.
Yeah. So. Things not too busy at the moment?
No, certainly not. Certainly not. Very quiet.
No, I know it's like that at the moment. And you've got a slight accent,
yeah,
Tasha.
Yeah.
What is it?
That's an Australian twang, I think they call it.
Yeah? Were you Aussie?
No. I worked for a time in France and in America. Yeah. And with some Australians.
Yeah, you've got yourself a sheila here, are you?
Yeah, I'll say.
Nathan, what do you do for your hobbies?
I sing. I sing a lot.
Oh, sing a wheel. We have got a few singers on the show. So what style do you like?
How about, do you know any Everly Brothers numbers?
Well, you start. I don't want to spoil it for you.
Okay, what about Dream?
Go on then.
Dream.
When I want you in my arms and I want you and all your charms whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream, 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 dream. When I feel blue in the night and I need you to hold me tight whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream. I could make you mine, taste your lips of wine. Time, night or day. Only trouble is she wins. I'm dreaming my life away. I need you so that I could die. I love you so. And that is why whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream.
Nice job. Well done. All right. Welcome to the show. It's been like this. Lovely. Good. All right. Yeah. I had to follow you there. All right. Hello, Eva. Is it Eva?
Yeah. That's right.
And Betty. Hello, Betty.
Hello.
How are you today?
Okay.
Nice to see you, Betty.
Lovely.
Betty, Adrian. All right, nice to see you, ladies. And where are you? First of all, what have you done, Eva?
Up here.
You've broken it, have you?
On Sunday. Before we came here.
So it's hurting a bit, is it?
Yes.
Yeah. All right.
Never mind.
Do you what, love?
Never mind.
Never mind. Oh, you look cheerful. So how'd you do that?
Dog.
Dog?
A dog.
A dog did it?
Yes.
Oh. In what way?
Straight over his back, hit me on the bottom of the legs, didn't see him coming at me.
Yeah.
Hit me on the bottom of the legs, went straight over his back and straight down on me.
Oh dear, was he on heat?
No. No.
Why did he go for you, Eva?
He loves her. Because he loves her.
Oh, because he loves her.
He's gorgeous.
Oh, you still like the dog then? He did mean it. Is he a big dog?
Yes, very.
Is it yours, Betty?
No, it's not mine.
It's my neighbour's.
It's your neighbour's?
Mine's Barney.
And yours is what?
Barney.
Barney.
Dog.
Yeah. What's Barney?
Barney's a... a Datsun cum terrier.
Is he?
Yeah, he's got Datsun legs and the terrier face.
Datsun's the long sausage thing.
Yeah, that's right. Is.
And he's got,
he's got the legs of the Datsun.
Yeah.
And the face of a
Toyota.
No.
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 What?
Terrier.
Oh, terrier.
Yeah.
And I haven't asked you where you're from yet, Betty.
Nottingham.
Both, and what, are you friends?
No, sisters.
What do you do? Do you work still?
No, no, retired.
Yeah, and you, Betty? What did you do before?
I was a silver service waitress.
And what about you, Eva?
No, I used to be a supervisor in the laundry factory.
Nice. Laundry.
Laundry?
No, I thought you said laundry.
Lingerie, Betty.
You have to say it, don't we?
We do, Eva, that's
we
right.
We do, yes.
And so what hobbies, what hobbies have you got, Betty?
Car maintenance.
Do you do the car?
Yeah. I'm 73 and I still can change a wheel.
Say that again.
I'm 73 and I can still change my tyre, my wheels. My oil change, my points and my plugs.
Oh, you do all the maintenance?
I can't do underneath now, like I used to. I used to go under with my husband underneath the car.
Oh, really? And what happened there? What was that like
then? Well,
we
had an Austin Cambridge and...
I used to have an Austin Cambridge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, the clutch had gone. Mm. Well, Les was at that end trying to get the clutch in. I'm at the other end holding the bell housing.
This in the garage?
Yes, in the garage. And... he kept saying, bring it a bit towards me, Bet. I says, have you got it in yet, Les? He says, no, I haven't. He says, oh, wait a minute, we've cracked it. We've cracked it. He says, bring your end towards mine. And then we bolted it up.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the car.
I know you're talking about the car. So
eventually we got it in and everything was okay.
Yes.
And we'll come out.
Doing well service. All right. Well, let's welcome them. There we are. Nice to see you. Good luck tonight. And you,
thank you, my dog.
All right. Hey, Kath. How do you do? Okay. And Anthony.
Hi, Michael.
And Kath, you married?
Yes.
We are.
Yeah, you are. And whereabouts are you from?
Manchester.
Manchester. Okay. And what do you do, Kath?
I work in an audiology department in a hospital. Everything to do. That's right.
It really is. ENT.
Yeah.
And Anthony, what do you do?
I'm a fireman.
You work for the fire service?
Yeah.
And have you also, how long have you been with the fire service?
4 years.
Four years, yeah. All right. So you enjoying it?
Yeah, it's great. Yeah.
Have you got any children?
No.
No?
Five hamsters.
Five? Oh, I see. How do you do that, Anthony? Is that...
A lot of practice, Michael. Yeah.
All right, well, we hope you end up doing well tonight, and Anthony's well done. OK, let's give a nice round of applause. Let's play the game. All right, the idea of the game is get from one side to the other. The first couple to get across gets a chance to go on a jackpot and win anything up to £5,000. You toss the coin and order on to decide who's going first. If your partners would like to go to the places, we'll start. Let's give them a bit of encouragement. And let's start the game. Here we go. Good luck, everyone. Right, you'll be OK getting across. There we go. First category is for you, Adrian. It's Mo Words is the category. Two, three or four?
Two.
Right. Please. A Detroit-based recording company?
Motown.
A form of work or art?
Mosaic.
That's right. Two moves of yours, you're on. OK. All right. Right, Natasha.
Okay.
Fine. First screen we'll give you absolutely free. Just like to come in here. We've got to watch for the hotspots. What is hotspot? Not? Okay, strike the screen. Off you go. Let's see what you've got. Stereo unit. You got a stereo unit. You want to bank that or are you going on?
What do you want to do?
You want to bank it or are you going on? You're moving on?
Yeah.
Okay,
move
Natasha.
On. Move on.
All right, let's see what's on the next one. Off you go. Ooh. Office bureau and the stereo unit, they're yours. All right. Go on to the next category, which is what a performance for you, Betty. Two, three or four?
Two.
Two. All right. For your first question, here we go. What sort of performance is Cinderella? The answer's up there.
Pantomime.
That's right. What sort of play would an audience at Hamlet be seeing?
Operetta.
No, it's wrong, Betty. No. Sorry, I have to take the answer. What sort of play would an audience at Hamlet be seeing?
A tragedy.
A tragedy's right. You take the two moves. OK. All right. Never mind, Eva. OK, you've just come forward, Kath. No, you've got that one already. That's for nothing. All right, strike the screen. A video recorder. Do you want to bank that or risk us living on that screen? What are you going to do? Going on. All right, OK, Kath. Strike the screen. Exercise equipment and a video recorder. There you are. OK, we go on to the next category. Back with you now, Adrian. The category is Sunny Isles. Two, three or four?
Two, please.
On which island is Palma?
Mallorca.
And on which island is Puerto de la Cruz?
Tenerife.
That's right, two moves are yours. OK. Wonderful. Right, Natasha, strike the screen. Let's see what you got. No. Never mind. OK, you've lost nothing there. That one's out of the way. We go on to the next category. Back now with you, Betty. It's musical instruments. What do you like on those, Betty?
For art, too.
All right, OK. What musical instrument was invented by a man named Adolf Sachs?
Saxophone.
All right, and what musical instrument does Nigel Kennedy play?
A trumpet. No, I'm wrong.
No.
No. Piano.
Well, why don't you just run through the lot there, Betty? We'll get that.
Sorry,
I'm sorry,
no,
love. OK.
Right, no.
So over to you again, Anthony.
Violin.
Violin's right, to yours. OK. All right. Strike the screen. Let's see what you got. Ooh, £150. Now, do you want to bank it? They've got to bank it. They're playing the game that way. OK, well done. All right. Back now with you, Adrian, and the category is country associations. Two, three or four?
Two, please.
With which country do you associate the sport of sumo wrestling?
Japan.
With which country do you associate Edam cheese?
Holland.
That's right, your two moves. OK. OK, Natasha, strike the screen. Mm-hmm. Silk pyjamas.
Move on.
They always move on from the silk
would be nice, though.
I don't know why. Edinburgh weekend, a weekend in Edinburgh and the silk pyjamas. All right, we're on to the next category, which is main ingredients. We need to get you going now, Betty.
Okay.
All right, okay, two, three or four?
Two.
It's all about food.
Yeah, two then.
Two, love?
Two.
Sure?
Yeah.
All right. What would you be making using mainly rolled oats and golden syrup?
Flapjacks.
That's right. And what would you be making using mainly almonds, eggs and sugar?
Brandy snaps. No?
No, I have to accept it. I'm sorry, okay. Betty. Never mind. What would you be making using mainly almonds, eggs and sugar, Anthony?
Macaroons.
Is that a guess?
Yeah.
All right, you've got it. OK, that's yours. You all right, Eva?
Yes. Taking it all in.
Yeah. OK, that one's out of the way. We go on to the next category, which is words for you. Adrian, two, three or four words?
Two, please.
Sorry, two or three?
Two.
Two. Please. With which word describes something that happens every 2 years?
Unilateral.
Is wrong, I'm afraid. Betty, you can pick this up. With which word describes something that happens every 2 years?
Exorcist. Accelerate. Stop it, Michael.
Betty, no, I don't.
Give over.
No.
Yeah.
I can't accept it.
No,
I'm sorry,
okay.
Betty.
Carry on.
All right. It's a brilliant answer, though. I'll give you that. That my way, Betty. You can have it for that.
Biennial.
Biennial's right. Which? Oh, yes. Oh, never mind. And which word describes someone who can speak two languages fluently?
Bilingual.
Bilingual's right, two moves are yours. OK. All All right, OK, Cass, track the screen, let's see what you got. A ball gown. Do you want to bank it or are you going on? Move on. You just want the ball to go to now, don't you? All right, let's see what we got. OK, a washing machine and a ball gown. They're yours. OK, we come on to the next category. Back with you, Adrian. The category is going to the movies, two or three. Going to the movies, two or three.
Two, please.
Right. Which of these film companies uses a roaring lion as its symbol?
MGM.
And which of these film companies introduces its film with a shot of a lady holding her arm aloft?
Columbia.
That's right, two moves are yours. OK. Oh, front screen, Natasha, let's see what you've got. Oh, that one's out of the way. OK, we're back now with you, Betty. And the category is weapons of the past.
Oh, yeah. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, Michael.
And there's no exorcist in this
one.
No,
all right.
Now, what are you like with, what are you like with weapons?
Well, I'm not very good at weapons. I don't know about...
Yeah.
Under the car, like, and things like that.
Under the car,
cars,
I know that, yeah. You don't really want a weapon under the car.
Under the car, no, no, I'm sure.
No.
No.
So, how many are you going to have then, Betty?
Two.
Two? All right. Which of these weapons was a kind of sword?
Which a rapier.
That's right. One more.
Yeah.
Now, which? Now, think of that. Don't rush into the
no,
answer, Betty.
No.
Which of these ancient weapons was a forerunner of the modern rifle? It came before.
Ballister.
Now, think about it, love.
Matchlock.
Yes! Oh, thank God you're still here, Eva. What are you going? All right, Eva. Oh, you've only got one arm. Bang it with that one. There you go. Let's see what you've got. £200. Now, do you want to bank it? What are you going on? You're going to go try the next
bank
one?
It. You can bank
go
it.
Go on.
Bank it.
Bank it or go on?
Bank it. You want to bank it?
You going on?
Bank it. What's she doing?
Hey?
Yeah. She's not. She's not doing it.
Fax machine and a £200. All right.
Oh.
Go on to.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, okay, you're off and running now. You've got a fax machine.
Oh, what's that?
you fax with it.
I see.
Yes.
Oh, one of them things.
Yeah. All right. Okay. All right. We're back now with you, Anthony. Two screens up there, a minimum of two questions. Royal events is the category. In which year was the Prince of Wales married?
1981.
And in which year did the Queen Mother celebrate her 85th birthday? Take a guess if you're not
86.
Sure. Is wrong, I'm afraid, Anthony. Adrian, do you know what it is? In which year did the Queen Mother celebrate her 85th birthday?
85.
1985?
Yeah.
You're right, that's it. You take the two moves. All right, OK, Natasha, strike the screen. Let's see what you got. £150. You're banking it or are you going on?
No, no.
You want to go on? All right, strike the screen. Let's see what you got. A Canaries holiday and £150. All right, OK? All right, you've got to decide whether you want to bank the £150 and the holiday in the Canaries or answer the main strike it lucky question. We'll find out what you're going to do in a couple of minutes' time. We'll see you after the break. See you then, all right? Thank you.
Congratulations, 82. You're straight on through to the next round.
Some people think life slows down in your 50s, but I'm just getting started and there's so much that I want to do. And yeah, I'll be retiring in a few years, so it makes sense to plan ahead. That's why I decided to learn more about over 50s life insurance from Cover Today. I know my lot don't need the money, but it's nice to leave a little something to help with funeral costs and other expenses, so they can spend their money on nicer things.
Cover Today are the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period.
Unlike other insurers who can make you wait up to 2 years, with Cover Today, you're fully covered from day one. And you're covered for the whole of your life, so you can just get on with things. Plus, unlike other things in life, the price never goes up.
Their claims process is really straightforward, so your loved ones will be looked after.
Learning more couldn't be simpler and can be done in just a few minutes. Go online or talk to their friendly UK team who will chat you through your options in just one phone call.
Cover Today are the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period. Get covered in minutes with no annoying trips to the doctor. With fixed monthly payments, prices start at just £4.42 a month. Plus, you get your choice of a £125 gift card. So stop putting it off and get it done. Then you can get on with doing something much more interesting.
To find out more about Cover Today, call our friendly UK team on 0800 9701 243 or visit covertoday.co.uk.
If you're over 50, you can have the time of your life without worrying how your family will cope when your time is up. Post Office Over 50s Life Cover is simple and affordable, and from a name you know and trust. You're guaranteed acceptance if you're a UK resident aged 50 to 80. There are no health checks, and it starts from just £1.15 a week. Plus, you can get free 24/7 GP access with the Health and Wellbeing Benefit. Come on, enjoy yourself. Safe in the knowledge Over 50s Life Cover will pay out money when you die, as a gift. Call our UK call centre now on 0800 169 1100 and choose your £100 gift card for amazon.co.uk, Tesco or M&S.
There's only one place to experience every magical moment.
Wicked.
Sky Cinema Wizarding World, available now.
Rob and Ramesh are taking on Crux.
You're going to be out there at the world's biggest dog show.
I don't think I can physically run around that on my own without a dog.
Three top tips then.
Okay.
Number one, eye contact with your dog.
Okay,
your
well, dog. I'm completely out now.
A new episode every Wednesday on Sky Max.
He was called the torso killer.
My game with him was to get him to confess.
What did you do with the body? Put it near a roof.
Oh, Queen Bee, you've buzzed too early again.
Thank you very much indeed. Welcome back to part two of Strike It Lucky. The situation we've got is Eva is just coming up to the halfway mark there. Kath is a couple away from the end there. And Natasha and Adrian, you've got this holiday on offer and £150. You bank it, it's safe, or you can answer the question. What are you going to do?
Answer the question.
You're going to answer the question? OK, the very best of luck. Who struck it lucky when he expanded his Virgin record company into the airline business?
Richard Branson.
You're going on to tonight's final one. Eva, you want to come back? There we are. There we are, by the steps. OK.
Yes.
Well done. There we are. Just... Well, there you come down then. All right, OK. That's it. All right, everybody congratulated everybody else. All right, Betty. OK, well done. All right, now, Kath and Anthony, you're taking away with you tonight a video recorder, exercise equipment, a ball gown, a washing machine and £150. You've done very well indeed. Lovely to meet you. All the best in the service. Good luck to you, Anthony. Well done. And Eva and Betty, a bit of bad luck with the categories there, eh, Betty?
Yes, it was.
Yeah, never mind. You're not going to go away empty-handed. You won a fax machine.
Yeah.
Which you can work out when you get home.
Yeah.
And £200 as well. All right. Thanks for meeting you.
Thanks.
And you know, come on. Well done.
Lovely.
Okay. Natasha and Adrian. Natasha and Adrian, you've already won an office bureau, a stereo unit, silk pyjamas, Edinburgh weekend, £150, a holiday in the Canaries, a chance now to win that jackpot. Let's give them all a nice round of applause. Natasha and Adrian. OK. Well done. OK, here's how we play the end game. You play the game as you did before, but this time you play the game horizontally and vertically. I'll ask you which move you want to make. You shout out top, middle or bottom. If you look at the screen there now, you can see we've got 10 arrows, 10 questions and 10 hotspots. If a question comes up, it'll be true or false. You give me an incorrect answer, it becomes a hotspot. For a correct answer, you'll get another move. You go for our top money tonight of £5,000, no more than two hotspots, £4,000, no more than three, and £3,000, no more than four. Before you make your mind up, the computer will now jumble them all up. That's it, they've gone, OK? Your prizes are safe, as always. It's up to you now what the money is. Three, four, or £5,000. What do you think they should go for? We've got going to do?
Five.
They're going for the 5,000. Let's have some of the best of luck. Adrian, you've got to come over here. There we are. Good luck to you. So right beside each other, about the same gap all the way across. Very best of luck. £500 for every successful move. So for your first 500, it's either the top, the middle, or the bottom. Where are you going to go?
Bottom.
Down the bottom for the first 500. Up you come. Ain't a great start, is it, Adrian? Never mind. OK, up you come. All right, that's one out of the way. We'll allow you one more. Just there. Top, middle, or bottom for your first 500. Up you come. Top. You going up the top? Yeah. Want to go up the top for the first 500? Be fair. Come on. Oh, I hate this. Come on. OK, all right, well, there's a two gone. You've got to now start getting... It has been done before. You've got to get right the way across, OK? Can't afford a hotspot. The question comes up, you've got to get it right. This time, for your first £500, and hopefully more, top, middle or bottom, where do you want to go?
Top.
Up the top? I want to go up the top for the first 500. Come on, be fair. Oh, question. OK, get this right, you've got the first £500. All right. Song and dance man Wayne Sleep was once engaged to Princess Diana. Is that true or false?
False.
£500, you're off. Here we go. OK, over you come. All right, for £1,000, top, middle or bottom? For £1,000, top, middle or bottom? Hang on.
Middle.
In the middle?
Middle.
In the middle for £1,000. Come on, be fair. Ooh. Question. OK. Premier John Major was once an artist model. Is that true or false?
False.
That's false. That's £1,000. You're on your way. OK. For £1,500, top, middle or bottom? Where do you want to go? For £1,500. We're going?
Bottom.
Down the bottom? They want to go down the bottom for a £1,500. Come on. Oh! Bad luck. Let's give a nice round of applause. Come in, Natasha. Don't worry. You've done well. You stand inside, Adrian. There you go. Just come in here. OK, let's have a look at the screens. Let's see where they all were. Look up there. Yeah. It's all very well after a bit. Never mind. You've done very well indeed. You're taking away with you tonight an office bureau, a stereo unit, silk pyjamas, a weekend in Edinburgh, a holiday in the Canaries, the money you won earlier, that's £1,150 as well. Is that OK?
Yeah,
and best of luck with your career, and look after yourself and your Natasha. And best of luck to each and every one of you, so we'll see you at the same time next week. Good night, God bless. All right, good night, thank you. Good night.
What B is a vintage game show hosted by the brilliant Simon Mayo and coming up next on Challenge. Answers on your screen if that's a little too tough for you. Weekdays at 5, it's time for the throwers and the knowers to get in play with Jim, Bully and Bullseye.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
You do all sorts of things when you're a parent. Bomb disposal, spit washing, taking out life insurance.
Hello, welcome to Smart Life Insurance. You're speaking to Kate. How can I help?
Hi, I'd like to get a quote, please.
OK, as long as you're a UK resident, aged 18 to 64, you can apply for a benefit amount up to £750,000. There's no medical or blood tests, just a few health and lifestyle questions. £100,000 of life insurance cover could start at just £6.89 a month in the first year.
That's less than I thought. And with that money, we could pay off the mortgage.
And with Smart Cashback, you'll get 10% of your first year's premiums back after 12 months.
I'll go ahead.
At Smart Insurance, we offer a 100% advance for terminal illness and a straightforward claims process. Plus, when you take out a policy, you'll get a £100 gift card. To get a quote today, call 0800 158 3030 or visit smartinsurance.co.uk.
Step into your future with learning that can take you anywhere.
This is really, really important on the side.
All by yourself. Listen to everybody, everybody say, be everybody else, can't you see?
The Open University. The future is open.
Testing 1, 2. We're ready.
Biggest bounce of the summer. Hey, my girl, we said. It's the biggest bounce of the summer.
It's a huge hit. Hey, what you said. How
outstanding. What a shot that is. If you're coming in, come down, play, play. It's a one-hander.
Watch by me.
Oh!
The return of the 100 next Tuesday live on Sky Sports.
The galaxy still needs its guardians.
You're an idiot.
I am Groot.
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, available now in Sky Store.
Arrows, bendy bullies, and checkouts. We've the ABC of darts right here. Bullseye, weekdays at 5 on Challenge.
Congratulations, number 3. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Blockbusters with your host, Simon Mayo.
Hello and welcome again to all new Blockbusters. Yes, it's the show where one player is up against two in their bid to make their way across the Blockbusters board. By answering general knowledge questions, our players can seize a hexagon with our solo player hoping to connect white to white, top to bottom, and our pair across the board, blue to blue. The best of three games, and the winner goes on to the legendary gold run. Ben from Bridgend will face his first gold run in just a moment, but first, please welcome his new opponents, Jill and Mel from Nottingham. Jill and Mel will talk to you in just a moment, but Ben, it's your first gold run. Are you ready, sir?
I think so, yes.
Okay, we wish you all the best. Put yourself on the hotspot. OK, Ben, there's your gold run board. You have 60 seconds to make your way across, connecting left to right, gold to gold. If you make it to the other side, you'll win your first gold run prize. You can pass on any question, as you know, and your time starts as soon as you tell me where you want to begin.
DW.
Comedian who swam the Channel and the Thames for
David
charity.
David Walliams.
Correct.
BN.
Words on the screen of a 24-hour channel to alert the viewer to a fresh story taking place.
Pass. I see.
Chilled version of a caffeine drink that is usually hot.
Iced coffee.
Correct.
NW.
Ubiquitous phrase to reassure that there isn't a problem and there's nothing to fret about.
No worries.
Correct.
GB.
Fitted during an operation to reduce the food intake of the seriously overweight.
Gastric band.
Correct.
SL.
A system of hand gestures used for communication
sign
by
language.
And for the deaf. Sign language is right. That's your gold run! Fantastic, and this is what you've won.
After your first gold run, you've earned the chance to put your feet up and watch a few repeats of Blockbusters. Well, now you'll be able to with your brand new 24-inch HD TV. With built-in digital receiver and crystal clear pictures, this is one prize that will keep you glued to the box.
That's a good prize.
Thank you very much.
That's very, very smart. You just passed on one question. Words on the screen of a 24-hour channel to alert the viewer to a fresh story taking place. It was breaking news,
oh, right.
Is what we wanted. But that was a blistering performance from you, Ben. Congratulations. Maybe there'll be many more. Back to your seat, please.
Thank you.
OK, so we have a new set of three. Jill and Mel, you're very welcome to Blockbusters.
Thank
You've already
you.
Said hello to Ben. Jill, you are a ward receptionist. Mel, you're a hospital nurse.
Yeah.
Is that where you met each other?
Yeah, I moved there about 2 years ago and Jill was a glamorous ward receptionist.
Well, I wouldn't say glamorous. I've been there 8 years, but I wouldn't say I'm glamorous.
Well, I think we would.
Oh, thank you.
Jill, is it... Now, this isn't very glamorous, okay. But apparently you can turn your tongue right round between your teeth.
I can, yes.
Could we...
I've got to... Show you how to do it, shall
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm not okay. sure that this will add to the glamour of things, but yes.
Well, I bet that looks awful.
Yeah,
that's,
you're right.
That's how you do it.
And Mel, you work in ear, nose and throat. Is that normal?
Not really, no, but Jill isn't very normal.
Thank you.
Well, it's good to see you getting on so well right at the very beginning of the game. Here's our next board. We have an L flashing top left. Let's play Blockbusters. Ben playing Jill and Mel. What L is a 10-letter word without any letter repeated that means a person who works at felling trees? Jill.
Is it a lumberjack?
It is a lumberjack. Yay! You got him just in time. Good start, you're on the board. Hexagon turning blue. Where would you like to go next?
Can we have a J, please, Simon?
Yes.
Thank you.
What J is the biblical name used in a derogatory way to describe... Ben.
Judas.
No, is the incorrect answer. Full question to Jill and Mel. What J is the biblical name used in a derogatory way to describe an immoral woman?
Jezebel.
Yes. Jezebel is right. Well done. Another blue hexagon is on the board. Jill and Mel, where would you like to go next?
Can we have a V, please, Simon?
Yes. What V in mathematics is a changing quantity as opposed to one which remains... Mel.
A variable.
As opposed to one which remains constant, variable is right. Ben, you're clapping very enthusiastically. You just need to get on the board.
I forgot I was playing.
Well, you were just enjoying it, really.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
Jill and Mel, where would you like to go next?
E, please, Simon.
What E received the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1921? Ben.
Einstein.
Einstein is right. You're on the board. First white hexagon of this game. Ben, where would you like to go next?
I'd like a W, please, Simon.
What W precedes it, meaning to improvise? Mel.
Wing.
Wing is right. Wing it. Where would you like to go next, Jill and Mel?
Yeah. Can we have a B, please, Simon?
Certainly. What B is the Oxfordshire town where you'd go to see a fine lady, Jill?
Is it Banbury?
To see a fine lady ride on a white horse. Banbury is right. A lot of blues on that board, Ben. Where would you like to go next?
OK, I think it's about time we had a P, please, Simon.
Certainly. What P are the strings you hold when you control expenditure? Mel.
Purse.
Purse is right.
Can we have an N, please, Simon?
Certainly can. What N was the Aswan High Dam built across to form Lake Nasser? Mel.
Nile.
Nile is right. Oh, yes, very good. We have a flashing blue board, one hexagon away from Blockbusters. Ben, you're going to have to be fast here, sir.
I think we're better for the S, please, Simon.
I think you probably should. What S occupy other people's property uninvited? Jill.
That will be squatters.
That will be squatters. Well done, that's Blockbusters. Well done, congratulations. You've got a game on the board. Ben, you've got a gold run. You know that you can do it, but you know that you're going to have to win this particular game that's coming up. Is it true that you applied to be on Blockbusters many years ago?
Well, I wasn't actually a student. I was young. I wanted to go on because I always really enjoyed it, but I didn't even get a reply. So.
Okay. Aww. Wow. I hope it's been worth the wait, Ben.
It has indeed.
Here's the next board. F flashing. That's where we're going to start. Let's play Blockbusters. What F completes the book title Harry Potter and the Goblet of... Mel.
Fire.
Fire is right. Well done, you're on the board.
So
have
a W?
Yep.
W, please, Simon.
Okay. What W is the British designer Vivienne...
Mel. Westwood.
Who's renowned for fashion innovation. Westwood is, of course, the right answer, yes.
We have a B, please, Simon.
What B is a world religion from ancient India that believes in karma? Ben.
Buddhism?
Buddhism is right, yes. And you're on the board, Ben. Where would you like to go next?
I'll have a K, please. Hang on.
What K means children's garden in German? Jill.
Kindergarten.
And is a nursery school catering for the very young. Kindergarten is right. And where would you like to go next?
Can we have a D, please, Simon?
Yes. What D is a general term for reading, writing and spelling difficulties? Mel.
Dyslexia.
Dyslexia is right, yes. Ben, it's very polite to applaud every time they get an answer right, but I think you've forgotten to play again.
She's too quick for me.
Where would you like to go next?
Can I have a P, please, Simon?
You certainly can, any time you like. You don't get extra money for asking for a P. What P follows got the or given the when someone... Ben.
Push.
When someone is sacked or dismissed, pushes the right answer. Yes. Yeah, I think you've worked out if you're not going to beat these ladies, you're going to have to interrupt, and it was a very good interruption.
Right.
Where would you like to go next?
I will take the S, please.
Okay. What S is a carpet with long tufts? Jill.
Shagpile. Yeah.
That every now and then makes a comeback from the 70s that would suit Austin Powers. Shagpile or shag is the right answer, yes. Can be one word or two, and that's why it's in the game. Where would you like to go next?
Can we have the E, please, Simon?
Yes. What E is the country Napoleon is said to have scornfully referred to as a nation of shopkeepers? Ben.
England.
England is the right answer, yes. So with Jill and Mel, one game up against current champion Ben, will they go on to win themselves and get on the gold run? Join us after the break. We'll find out. See you then.
One of our biggest expenses is planning a funeral. A traditional service with all the formalities involved can cost more than £4,000. Not everyone can afford that. But the good news is that Distinct Cremations offer a simpler alternative for less than half that price. With their plan, you get a fuss-free cremation with no hidden costs or extra bills to pay. They even offer a money-back guarantee. So for a dignified farewell without spending more than you need, call Distinct Cremations for this free guide. You'll be in very good company.
To find out more, call Distinct Cremations for a free guide on 0800 047 8552. That's 0800 047 8552. Or visit distinctcremations.co.uk.
Oh, God.
Hey, Tim. Come and look at these old photos of Grandad.
Oh, I miss him. But at least he had a good send-off.
Yeah, we did him proud.
He must have saved up like mad. What's a funeral cost these days?
Well, they say it's about £4,000. But by the time you add cars, flowers, food and everything else, it's more like £6,000. But thankfully, your Grandad always said it paid to have proper life insurance.
He was smart.
He was. So I took his advice. I wanted to make sure that you wouldn't have to find that sort of money at short notice.
British Seniors has been chosen by more than 200,000 people across Britain to protect their families. With a guaranteed cash payout up to £10,000 and 100% of claims paid, Over 50s Life Insurance is a great way to help make sure your loved ones aren't left struggling with funeral costs or outstanding debts when you die. You can arrange cover in just one phone call. Prices start from just £4.32 a month. If you're a UK resident aged 50 to 80, you're guaranteed to be accepted. Plus, your monthly payments are guaranteed to stay the same, and you're covered for the whole of your life. And when you take out a policy, you'll receive your choice of a free £125 gift card.
Come on, you. Nap time. You need your sleep so you can be smart like your nan.
Yes, you do.
To get a quote, call our friendly UK team now on 0800 014 2399.